my favorite here. Today's KCR3 Kitchen. We're going cook-free this summer with some summer meals. You don't need a stove. You don't need a flame. Nothing. I'm joined this morning by sous chef Scott Ostrander. He's from Red Rabbit, kind of one of the hottest new restaurants in Sacramento area. First off, good morning to you, and congrats to all your success. How's the business going so far? You've been open 6 months now?
Yeah, 6 months. It's been really busy, and we've kept up with the trends and changing our menu, and we've had a lot of fun.
Very good. Good to be busy when you're a restaurant.
Absolutely.
For sure. All right, so what we're doing is we're doing all things melon, and these are some very, this is the finished product right here, and these are some very interesting offbeat takes on ways to use melon and playing off of that very unique melon flavor, right?
Exactly.
Okay, so what's the first one we're going to show us here?
Well, it's summer, and we're using a black watermelon, which is black just because of its rind. It comes from Vieira Farms, which is local here.
Right.
And
let's turn that around for folks here. I mean, look at how dark this melon is real quick.
I mean, that is a dark melon.
It's also called an imagination watermelon.
Okay, very cool. So
we cut it up, and we're looking for geometric shapes here. So we're going to go with squares and then circles and then triangles.
Mm-hmm.
So just kind of square it off and make a couple of squares. And
very nice, very nice.
Wrap it in a little bit of shaved cucumber.
And you've got one of these things, which...
A mandolin, yeah.
A mandolin. I've seen it marketed for $19.99, the French mouli as well, but this is completely different.
Let me tell
correct?
You, it is absolutely essential to any kitchen at home or
one
in
of these,
the workplace.
And I wish I did. So anyway, but it makes this really cool strip, right?
Yeah, it does, and it's very simple.
Look at that.
It's great for salads.
I'm excited. I would just shave cucumbers all day. Right. All right. Awesome. Thank you very much for demonstrating.
So we've got that. And what this sits on is a bed of tzatziki sauce. And we have a recipe for that online.
And this looks really good, too. And, I mean, this has got everything like the dill.
It's got dill. It's got cucumber, sour cream, yogurt, a little bit of parsley, salt.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not tangy, but it's kind of... acidic from the
right.
sour cream.
This is good. I mean, you probably had this with falafel, things like that.
Absolutely.
Too, or whatever. All right, and then you're topping this with?
Just a little bit of feta and a little bit of mint, so it's very Greek oriented.
Yummy, right? Kelly's over there just staring at this here.
And our second one here, the circle, this is the yellow watermelon, which not too many people are familiar with.
Right.
It also comes from Vieira Farms.
Mm-hmm.
And we top this with a small bit of fresh mozzarella,
nice.
Cherry tomato from Del Rio Farms in West Sac,
nice.
And then a little bit of balsamic vinegar.
Very good, and love that. And that's a very thick, almost syrupy balsamic reduction.
Absolutely.
Put that in a pan.
Slightly reduced.
You reduce it. Do you need to add anything in the pan?
Nope.
Nothing.
Nothing.
Okay, and you want a nice quality balsamic, too.
I recommend an aged balsamic.
An aged balsamic.
But some people can't, find it in a store or something.
Right.
So
it'll do.
Balsamic.
Yeah. And then the last one here.
And the last one here is a triangle, and this is a regular red seedless watermelon.
Mm-hmm.
And it's topped with a little bit of manchego cheese, a thin slice, cut in the same geometric shape, a little bit of basil folded over, and a tomato vinaigrette.
Now, is manchego cheese, talk to me, is that like really stinky cheese or what kind
Not really.
Of cheese?
It's
like
very
a strong,
smooth.
Pungent?
I think it's smooth, it's subtle, it can be a little dry at times, and it's a Spanish cheese. It's great.
Very good. All right, can I sample here real quick? Kelly, do you want to come over here and sample? Because I know you're just staring at these. Here, since I'm a gentleman, I will let you try. Which one do you want? Do you want the tzatziki, the balsamic, or the...
This one's on a stick. It will
this is manchego.
Fun.
Yeah, it will. It will. All right, very good. So she's taking the manchego, and I'm taking the tzatziki. By the way, all these melons kind of have a unique, kind of flavor profile,
Absolutely.
Right? I mean, they all
They're
taste
all
kind of individual.
Really
so anyway,
I love Red Rabbit. I love your drinks.
Mm.
Maybe that could be the next section. Although
Absolutely.
I won't be here for a long time, but if you could do the drinks.
And this is a good summertime.
Let's do it.
Yeah, that'd be great.
It's
a unique summertime appetizer, right?
Three of these watermelons will feed, 25 people appetizers.
No, very good. And it's really not that expensive either.
Mm-mm.
Five
bucks.
You just comprehend making your own tzatziki. Yeah. A little fresh mozzarella, about probably your biggest expense right there.
Absolutely.
I would imagine. All right, Scott Ostrander. Excuse me. Thank you for being with us, man. I appreciate
nice
it.
Nice to meet you.
Absolutely. And again, the Red Rabbit. Come see this guy. You won't be disappointed. You guys are doing great things down there.
All right. Thank you.
Thanks. We'll be right back.
This is really good.